I've acquired 3 second passports. I now have 4 citizenships, and I help many people around the world acquire a second passport and a second nationality. And I've talked many times about the importance of having a second passport, and you can get one very quickly. For example, by citizenship by investment, you can invest into a country like St. Kitts and Nevis, which I did, and get a passport in as little as 5 to 6 months. But now I'm going to talk about the importance of getting a strong second passport. And what I mean by strong is a country that you're actually going to live in, and a country that has consular protection around the world, a country whose economy is growing, and a country whose relationships with other countries around the world are improving. Now, it's a reality that you can get one of these passports, you can start traveling, you can have asset protection, you can start bank accounts in one of these passports, but the reality is that they don't have embassies, they don't have consulates around the world, they have just a couple of embassies and consulates and missions all over the world. And their relationships with other countries, mainly in the West, is deteriorating. They're losing visa-free access. And these are not countries that we're actually going to live in. That's why I'm a big proponent of getting stronger citizenships, or bigger citizenships. For example, the Republic of Serbia. They have over 100 embassies and consulates around the world and have good relationships with the East and the West. It's a citizenship that allows you to travel to pretty much any country outside of the West that you want to go to, and also including the Schengen area. And it's a country that is improving in visa-free travel. It's improving in more countries that they're getting access to. And also it's a country that you might want to live in the future. The same thing with Mexico. It's a giant country where you can live in. Many beautiful cities, huge population of over 100 million people, is one of the leading countries in the world when it comes to embassies and consulates abroad. It's number 15 in the world with most embassies and consulates all over the world, including more than 50 diplomatic missions in the United States alone. These are countries that if you're a citizen and something happens to you around the world and you have the citizenship of one of these countries, they will take care of you. And it's also countries that you can rely on living there. Because if you have a St. Kitts passport, that's great for traveling, that's great for using it for asset protection, but you're actually not going to go live in St. Kitts. You're always going to live on a residency permit or a golden visa or an elite visa or something else in another country. And really quick, if you want to get yourself a second passport, second citizenship, click that link in the description. Me and the Wealthy Expat team will get on a call with you, see all the options that you have, and see how we can help you. Now, these are countries like Serbia and Mexico that you might actually want to live in. Another country, which is obviously citizenship by investment, but a much stronger and at a higher level, is Malta. By investing $1 million into Malta, you become a Maltese and a European citizen. So obviously now you have more than 25 countries that you can live in, that you can call home. They have diplomatic missions all over the world. And obviously you're part of the EU, which is good and bad, and you're subject to the regulations and the restrictions later in the future. You can actually live in Malta. It's an English-speaking country. It's absolutely beautiful, and you'll be protected no matter where you go around the world. So getting a St. Kitts passport, any other citizenship by investment from the Caribbean is great, but you need to look at the higher level. You need to add on more passports to that portfolio, specifically if you're renouncing, for example, US citizenship. If you're renouncing your US passport, maintaining that St. Kitts citizenship, that is not enough. Getting, for example, a Serbian passport, a Mexican passport, a Maltese passport on top of that, a Turkish passport as well. Turkey is a country that you might actually want to live in. Has almost 100 million people population, has diplomatic missions all over the world, and is a passport that you can get relatively easy in 3 to 4 months by investing into property in Turkey. When it comes to growth of the country and the economy, all these passports that are mentioned are getting better. For example, Mexico, which I mentioned before on why you should get a Mexican passport, you should have it as part of your portfolio. Mexico is now a manufacturing hub. Things made in Mexico are becoming more and more popular. The population of Mexico is becoming more skilled. Some places are becoming safer. A lot more people are going and visiting Mexico and investing into Mexico and building hotels and building facilities in Mexico. Mexico is truly developing at a fast pace, and it's going to get better and better over time. People are making more money, and overall the population is improving, the passport is improving, its relationships with the rest of the countries are improving, and its consular protection is getting bigger and bigger over time. And the last big player, which is sometimes called the Centurion passport, that passport that if you could get it, you would get it because it's just the best in the world and it's improving over time, is the United Arab Emirates. The UAE has over 100 diplomatic missions all over the world. If you check the map, it pretty much covers the entire world that you can get protected by the United Arab Emirates. Obviously, most of the population speaks English, and it's a passport that is possible. It requires a lot of investment, it requires a lot of contribution to the country, but you should start looking at this level of passport. If you're a multimillionaire, don't just stick to Caribbean citizenship by investment. Add on these other passports so that you can have a country that you might actually want to live in. Also, it's part of the GCC, so you can go live in Saudi Arabia. Later, Saudi starts building these massive projects in the Red Sea and overall becoming a massive hub for expats and tourists. You can also go live in Saudi Arabia or any other country in the GCC. The UAE is improving, attracting more millionaires, attracting more businesses to come to the UAE, and having this passport will put you above pretty much anybody else. And once they get access to the US and Australia, it'll be really the best passport in the world. Start looking at this next level. Don't just stick to Caribbean citizenship by investment, because yes, you can get more freedom, more asset protection, but you're missing out on so many things that these stronger passports give you. If you're interested in getting a better second passport, a second citizenship, I actually made a video on how to get a United Arab Emirates golden visa and citizenship by contributing to the UAE. It's not as easy as contributing to the Caribbean, but you can definitely take advantage of that if you're at a high level net worth. Check it out right here. UAE golden visa and citizenship options and new possibilities that you can take advantage of. Check them out right here.